Greetings, YouTube community, sports fans, nation, and worldwide. You've entered the Sports Opinion Log. I'm your host, slash your boy, Lex Anderson. And in today's video, well, we just got some NBA stuff to talk about. Don't you agree? But we're not going to talk about game recaps. No, we're going to talk about players' behaviors. No look passes. Why not? Let's just get to victory here. And, you know, I'll just say it for what it is. Minus the curse words, because I'm sure that the Sports Opinion Log with Lex Anderson is very family orientated. White people are racist, plain and simple. We'll just leave it at that. But then, of course, to say that would be to generalize, right? So let's say white people in Utah are racist. White people in Boston are racist. But we'll just stick to Utah for now, because once again, someone's getting too close. Someone's foaming at the mouth like a rabid dog. And so, you know, I'm out there in Facebook on various basketball and NBA groups that I'm in, and I'm making my comments to see what other people are going to say. And here's what I got. Number one, there is a difference between trash talking and being a heckler. There is a big difference between Kevin Hart and Spike Lee and some white guy or, yeah, some white man or guy or teenager who gets a ticket and wants to talk extra outrageous bullshit, okay? Wasn't it just a couple of weeks ago that Westbrook went flying into the stands and some white man's kid pushes him or pokes him and the media wants to say, well, he's a white kid. He should know the difference between right and wrong. You fucking think so? I would think so. Who are you to poke and push a player? And did we forget last year, or was it earlier this year, that Patrick Beverly, was being verbally disparaged by some white kid, some white teenager who turned out to be the son of a general manager or an owner of a team? See, the problem is that when I say white people are racist, see, it's all social, and economical. Because look at the people going to the games. You have HD. Look at the people in the front row. They're all white. And I'm not talking about a few black people who are celebrities. The regular fan, the average fan who's sitting front row, they're white. I don't see no black people or people of color in the front row disparaging, insulting players. No grown man should ever be telling another grown man something about getting on his knees the way you should be. What? Which is why for this video, I'm wearing the throwback jersey. You think Isaiah Thomas had a great time when he was out there playing in racist Boston for the Detroit Pistons? You know, I remember many years back when J-Lo, who's now engaged to A-Rod, congratulations, when she was dating Ben Affleck, and she was trying to make a man out of him. Remember Desi Robin 23, my girl? And I will never forget, because the Lakers were winning championships, the Lakers called a timeout, Kobe went to sit down, and Ben Affleck was sitting next to Kobe Bryant. So it was Kobe, Ben Affleck, and J-Lo. And I said to my girl, oh my God, I know that the NBA sells tickets on the floor, but I didn't know that they put you goddamn next to the damn players. And therein lies the problem. The fans are too close. The camera crews are too close. The NBA, for all its corporate greed, needs to push some people the fuck back. Now, of course, you can't tell people what not to say. Should Westbrook have consulted NBA security to say, hey, you know, there's a racist fan saying some extra shit. And then the fan had the nerve to be on TV. It's like these people want attention. You know, I've gone to Yankee games because I'm not going to Knicks games because the Knicks are losers. I've gone to Yankee games and I've booed. Sometimes a girl will look at me like, damn, you're booing pretty hard. And I'm like, I got to get my money's worth. But I don't say nothing degrading, not that they would hear me anyway. But why should I be yelling like an obnoxious asshole saying derogatory racial things. And this, of course, is out there in white ass cracker Utah. Come on, let's be real. Places like Utah, places like Boston, yeah, they can be vicious, but there's an extra tinge of racism. So to the white people who want to compare Kevin Hart and Spike Lee talking to Joel Embiid or Harden, you can't equate them at all because those are celebrities joshing with other celebrities. It's in fun. You might hear Kevin Hart saying that Harden can't shoot, but I'm sure he's not talking about Harden's family. He's not talking about his mother. These fans have no conscience. And these white people think they could say whatever the fuck they want to say because they bought a ticket. But that's not how it goes. Now, to add on to that, there was also a clip where Dolan, the owner of the Knicks, was told by a fan to sell the team. And Dolan told the fan, you don't like it? You don't have to be here anymore. You can enjoy watching the games from your TV. Now, I agree with that. You know why? Because if I was the owner of a team, if some stupid-ass fan who knows the team sucks, who knows the team is bad, wants to have his, what, 15 minutes of fame? Well, guess what? I'll give you your 15 minutes and then some, because I will make sure that my security guard and my security personnel will pull you to the side, take down his name, take down his number, make sure you never again in your lifetime have the privilege of buying a ticket to see the team that I own play. There's a big difference, the haves and the have-nots. So next time you want to talk about how crappy my team is, enjoy the view from your living room or the local bar, loser. Yeah, I'm fine with that. But what I'm not fine with, since we're going on a fan player thing, I caught this thing on ESPN last night, which I made sure to save. I said the name. I meant to say the nationwide sports leader. Klay Thompson says that the fans need to give more energy for their games because they lost to the Suns. Final score on that one was 115-111 as the Suns win their first road game against a Western Conference team. They were 0-19 and their first win against the Warriors, who had beaten them 18 straight times. So let me make sure I get this correct from what Klay, what does Klay Thompson want? Let's see. So we expect our fans to kind of bring that from the jump. It's like us, though. You can't bring it every night, but it still helps. It doesn't matter if we're playing the Suns or the Bucks. Whoever it is, we need that energy from them because we feed off of that. Okay, well, good news, Klay Thompson. I did the job of going online to see how much your team is earning this season. Let's see. This season, Klay Thompson is earning $18 million. Draymond Green is earning $17.5 million. Andre Iguodala is earning $16 million. And the heavy hitters, Kevin Durant, who suffered an ankle contusion, tisk, 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 shame, 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 is earning $30 million. And the top breadwinner is Steph Curry, earning $37.5 million. So Klay Thompson, I'm sorry that the fans aren't energized enough for you. I would expect for you, being a professional athlete, to bring the energy, knowing that you're getting goddamn, how much again? Nearly $19 million. You can't bring the pain. You can't bring the emotion yourself. You're 24-10 in Oracle Arena, talking about how, oh, we're trying to do it for the fans. You're not doing shit for the fans, because next season you're leaving the loyal fans to go to your billion-dollar new home, privately financed by Chase. Make that $1.6 billion, by the way. So enough is enough. And speaking of enough, I've come to the end of this video. If you've come this far into the video, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about it. Well, not me, but the content of the video, obviously. And to be in the know, next best thing, subscribe to the video, to the channel. Press that button to your left and the bell icon to your right. Ding! Press it to stay updated and informed for any and all upcoming future videos. I thank you for tuning into this video. This is your boy Lex Anderson doing what I do best, popping this authentic throwback Isaiah Thomas Piston jersey. Woo! I'm signing out. Special shout out to my IGTV family. Gotta keep it within 10 minutes, you know. Later.